Hi everyone, welcome to this new Gamerside Live. Tonight we are going to show you Fallout 4 running as good as it can on a PlayStation 4. And well, as usual, Driftwood is going to do the playing and most of the talking.
No, because as usual, since you know now what I've said during the French live stream, you're going to help me.
Ready?
Because I spent a week playing Fallout 4, and like I said in the beginning of the French stream, it was not an easy thing for me to leave Tomb Raider to you and to spend that much time on Fallout 4, although I was actually looking forward to playing the game, but I've had a rough week trying to like it, as you know. But you know, you're not going to.
Yeah,
agree.
Sorry. I was typing some stuff on NeoGAF about it, and I didn't want people to hear the keyboard. So I was on mute. And to be honest, I didn't really listen about.
Yeah. So I was just saying that I've had a rough week playing.
Oh yeah, yeah. I think it was the most rage I ever seen you spit out.
Well, except maybe
about a game.
Yeah, except for that one time when I was trying to that drift event in.
Oh yeah, in Drive Club.
In
but
Drive Club.
That it was a one-time event. It was not 5 days of continuous raging.
Well,
until one day you say, "Oh, it's not so bad."
Yeah, that's you know. Stockholm speaking, actually.
Could be, yeah.
It's really true that I've had a hard time accepting the, you know, frame rate issues. I can live with the graphics as they are, even though, well, this actually looks pretty nice when you are in the forest like this. Yeah, atmosphere is very nice. And I don't just mean because of the music, the radio station I chose, but it definitely looks very nice when you are in the wild.
Oh, sorry, I've got a call. Sorry about that.
Oh, well, that's the first. And but yeah, in the cities usually, and the interiors, they look, most of them, well, almost every single one of them, they all look very, very bad. And I didn't have high expectations in terms of, you know, graphics and everything. I mean, it's a Fallout game, and but I was hoping for more consistency in, you know, in terms of frame rate, and also I have to say I
sorry about that.
I hope
first, indeed.
The game would look a tad better than it does. And so I wanted to start with the first settlement, which actually is the place where the main character used to live before the war 200 years ago. I'm not going to go into details. Maybe you know the basics, but. Yeah, you 200 years ago, there was the nuclear war, and you sort of wake up 200 years later, and you discover the world, and you're after something, and it's nothing really new, but it actually gives you some incentive to, well, at least for the character to continue, although at the same time it's odd to see that the main character, my character is female, but that she would take her time to do other things instead of just rushing to you know, through the main quest, because it's actually very personal. But I won't say more. So this is my first settlement.
Hypothetically speaking, do you think you could complete the game by doing just the main quests?
I believe that I'm not sure it would be doable. I think you still need to upgrade your character, and you know, a few of the side quests can help with that. But at the same time, I've never really felt that, you know, there were places where I couldn't go because I was too weak in the open world. So, for example, the first time I encountered a Deathclaw, which is a huge beast, and it's pretty dangerous. I was level 15 or more, and I had to use the fat man to get rid of them and make sure that I would not be killed instantly. But sometimes you get an enemy where with a skull next to its next to the name, or it's not really a name,
the type
of enemy. And you tend to think that, okay, that's means that it's going to be hard to beat, but it's still doable. Takes some time.
And
but
is there level scaling for the enemies like in Skyrim?
I'm afraid I'm not sure I can say yes or no. It's just, like I said, I've never felt like I was, I was arriving somewhere and, oh God, the enemies are too strong. I have to get out. But it always seemed manageable. There was a house I entered one day, thinking it was, I was following the Freedom Trail, and it was a mistake. I should have stayed outside because the Freedom Trail is just outside. It's not inside. At least that was not the building I was supposed to enter. And there were like this big giant monsters that, looked a bit like,
okay, we've got
crabs or something.
Interesting question.
Yep.
From Balazm. Are the NPCs always that inactive all the time when you don't move?
Well, they walk a bit. I have to say that I don't spend much time. I haven't spent much time in the settlement. Usually, I just do my stuff, and so you have your sidekick following you around. And the others, they move more or less. And some of these people actually didn't know because they arrived because the settlement is more or less okay. So they just happened to come because they heard that there was a nice settlement in the area, and which is why you need to upgrade it if you want to welcome more people, because you need enough beds, you need enough food and water supply and everything. And I'm going to show you that if you press, if you hold the...
Is there a wait option that would allow you to wait until it's daytime?
Sure. Look at this. Just need to sit. Oops, sorry. To sit. And when you sit, you wait.
All right.
So I'm just going to wait.
8 hours. Seems good.
Yeah, 10 hours.
We can see the...
10 hours in a chair, that's what I do every day. Nothing new to report. But I could have slept also, because there are beds here, and then, your health regenerates. Doesn't cure your rats, meaning if you're, the red bar is the radiation I took. And so the more you have, the less health, maximum health you can have. So you need to get this cured either by going to the doctor, which is actually not very expensive. It's like 40 caps. Or you have, if you have right away kits, you can use that. But buying them is a ripoff. So, or you can actually craft them if you want. So crafting, you can craft weapons here. And you can see here that it actually tells you that you don't... Well, I don't have the necessary rank to upgrade this, for example, here, but I have all that was needed to craft it in my, in the... Everything I collected was enough to upgrade if I wanted to. And here I still need to be ranked 2, so I can't either. So that's just something I can do, for example, here. This is a weapon I found, so it's already been modified. And usually, see, I don't have the necessary oil to do it, so I can't. And here, I don't have the rank. So, yeah. Of course, when I want to show something, I can't. But for example, if I take one of the the weapons I have. I think it's something I actually did change here. Not that short barrel. Can't remember, because some of the weapons I had and I upgraded that I don't know if that's one I actually upgraded a bit, I think, with a reflex sight here. For this, I will need to get crystal and more crystals.
So if you upgrade it, you will see it on the weapon?
Yeah, you will.
When you use it, yeah.
Yeah, you will. So you can upgrade your weapons, you can also upgrade your armor, but I don't have any, so I can't show you at the moment. I actually decided to keep the one of the outfit I found on a boss that worked for me. And this is the workshop that I can use to interact with the environment. So this is, you know, things I actually put for food here. There's a water pump. If you don't like, this street lamp, you can scrap the street lamp and you get some something you can use then in your workshop to build other things. So anything, well, not anything, but a lot of things can be scrapped like this. And even inside, you know, where we can move the chair, put it where you want.
That's much better.
And if you don't like this, well, you can scrap it. It's really, it's a funny thing to do actually, but there's no real reason to do it either. You know, it's more like, okay, let's waste a bit of time and make people happy. And I actually have a few settlements. The only one I actually took the time to take care of. And that green line over there, whatever you call it, it's basically the limit of your settlements, which means you can interact with things and you know, build things inside the circle, but you can't do it in the rest of the world, which means
right. You
can't, you know, scrap things when you're in the open world. So you can, you know, build structures made of wood or, you know, like walls, for example. If, you know, a house you think is, of course I'm not going to find any with a wall that needs repair, but it's not something you have to do. It doesn't make much, for example, here.
So someone is asking about the third person perspective.
Sure. Can you show you that in a bit? Okay, so... Oh no, I've left because I left the zone. So more or less it works with the controller to do this, although sometimes it could be, you know, the view is not the best. Like here, for example, it's hard to be precise. And then, there you go. You can see that it's a bit better now, but still not the best. So third person view is here, and just like in the other games, you can modify it if you really want. Not too sure how though, because maybe I have to hold the touchpad, but it actually launched the workshop interface, so I'll try outside. So see, you can add beds and things and chairs and decorations and power supplies and defense also. And basically, so that I can show you the other settlements I have.
So are there any options to automate the settlement stuff, or is it all manual?
It's all manual. If, you know, more people arrive and they need more beds, you need to come back and, you know, build some beds and craft some beds, and if they need more supplies, also it's on you. You can't ask anyone. You know what the funny thing is? Oh no, okay. What was happening when I was in? Oh no, the Pip-Boy wouldn't actually open by pressing the circle button. So the workshops I have is actually the settlements I've helped. And there, as you can see, that not a lot of them are very happy, except for the one I have, and even the one I'm in now, they think the defense is not good enough for them. So I should try to upgrade it. But the happiness rate is pretty good, you know. In the beginning, it was probably around 50. So I'm pretty happy with that. But the others, well, I didn't take the time to take care of them. And I don't really care, to be honest. But Sanctuary Hills, you know, it used to be my home. So I try to do as best I can to make it a nice place.
Yeah, it shows.
Well, you know, it's you can't bring back, you know, everything back to, you know, brand new state. So try to do what I can.
He's asking if the weapons show on your body in third person view.
Good question. I haven't played much in third person view. Nope. Unless you, of course, magically it appears when you.
Right. Well, it's not bad.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, the third person view is almost serviceable now.
It's better than it used to be. Although animations in general, you know, enemies and pathfinding also sometimes, well, not the best. But I'm gonna change the radio.
Yeah.
Back to Diamond City. You know, get a bit of a retro vibe. You see, it's raining now. So there's a, you know, some rain effects. Well, actually no puddles or anything. But, well, it looks wet. And sadly, I can't see any, nothing on the screen. Usually there are. You know, there's water flowing a bit.
Maybe if you look up?
No. It's just, I don't know why. Right. Maybe it's when you are in the power suit.
So, Esdarts is asking.
Yeah, it's in the power suit. That's right.
What?
I think it might be just when you are in the power suit, you know, the big armor.
Maybe.
It could be. Or maybe it depends on something else.
That's asking, how are the FPS mechanics? Does it feel more like a regular FPS? Like Wolfenstein, Halo, or Call of Duty?
Well, it's not in that, if you, you know, it's not because you aim properly that you're going to, you know, actually hit your target precisely, or that they're going to lose as much health as they would in a first-person shooter. And that's because it's a role-playing game, so there's, you know, statistics involved. But overall, I think I've used it way, you know, I've been playing real-time more than in Fallout 3, where we use the VATS a lot more. And well, it works probably a bit more like a first-person shooter, but problem is with the frame rate issues there are on consoles. It's sometimes a bit difficult to, you know, to play as you would in any other first-person shooter, where usually frame rate is solid, and that's not the case. And the drops can be pretty huge, as you probably saw. Actually, a place I just discovered. And yeah, you know, sometimes 15 frames per second. That's, you know, half 30. Actually, doesn't look very nice here.
Not really.
No. Which is the problem, the main problem of the game. Like I was saying in the beginning, it's just sometimes it just looks ugly, and there's no
so
other.
So people are still asking for third person view.
Okay, so you can see my wet helmet. Not too sure how. I realized that I've never tried combat in third person view.
No, it's as good a time as ever to give it a try.
Sure, just that as you see also, when you're in the wild, you don't get attacked that much, which is, well, it's good, I guess, in a way, But at the same time, for some people, it might be a bit of a problem because you feel the world is pretty empty. But still, you'll be attacked by mutated dogs or death claws, as I was saying before. Raiders, of course.
So yeah, this is a place you've never seen before. So
yeah, no,
no idea what's going to happen.
No, I don't know. So see, so Piper is coming along. I like Piper probably because I've been flirting with her and she's never said no. Well, though nothing really happened, but she's never refused the compliments. Even though I'm playing females, which is it's a bit of a Mass Effect.
Oh, there's vibe. Someone there.
Well, actually, it's not a threat.
Yeah,
but
it's not hostile.
No. Okay. Can I? I could try ask for money, as you can see. Although I've upgraded my charisma quite a lot. Yellow, it's not a certain, it's not going to work for sure, but I'm going to try.
I could probably help for a few caps extra. I was going to give you
something anyway. Okay, so it worked. And actually how it worked with so let's try more money. So it should be more difficult because it's orange, but there's always a chance, so why not?
Not sure if I'm up for it. A couple more caps might change my mind though. Not going to make
this easy. Okay, well, this guy actually pretty easy to convince. I don't think I'm going to try to get even more money. Although, in the world of Fallout, if you don't have money, well, you're going to have to loot a lot. You will not to survive.
Now, what are you really up to here? Maybe I got some
friends who like to ghost balloons. Woohoo!
Maybe. Yeah, probably you should have tried the give me more caps. You going to help or what? Alright, let's try.
You want this pump fixed, right? Throw in a few more caps and you've got a deal. Okay,
125. Oh my gosh.
Wow. So much charisma.
Yeah, it never happened to me before. So it could be because I added 1 point at the end of the French live stream. So I can help. I like his hat also. Okay, it's not going to be very fun if it's just repair the pipes just like I did repair the wires in the boat before. In the French live stream. I really love the music.
Yeah.
I could almost sing. Which I'm not gonna because I don't wanna please Esdarts too much. Although he would like to hear you, I think, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, well I'm sure he would change his mind very quickly if he could ever hear me singing, but it's not going to happen.
I don't think. Maybe on the on the road to Cologne.
At one time maybe, but.
So it might be stupid, but where's the objective marker? Because he asked me to, unless it's not. What if? Pull the plug, okay. So you accept a quest, but it doesn't actually activate. Yeah, that's a...
Yeah, that, it's a bit odd.
Strange choice, yes. Usually it does. Don't know why. It's probably the Gamerside Live effect.
Well, it's the Fallout 4 effect. It's...
Oh, frame rate is even bad here. It's just... Can I take anything here? Oh, there's... I can... take things. It's not stealing, it's not red. There's still the Oops.
You can do it.
I could actually break a pin. I don't know.
So the $1,000 question.
Yep.
Did you encounter many bugs?
a few. I wouldn't say many. And you can see that in one of the videos where where I killed a guy in the stairway, and the guy fell down, but he actually passed through the stairs and appeared just in the ceiling and fell down again and then disappeared through the stairs again.
Yeah,
and then
I saw the video. Yeah,
yeah. And that was fun. I would say I thought it was fun. I also had like bugs when smoke would become like big ass polygons, I didn't understand what was going on, because it felt I was playing, I was back in 1982 playing video games. I haven't encountered any game breaking bugs or, you know, problem with quests, though I know there are some, probably more towards the end as you progress, and I haven't been able to have the time to complete the end, and I really don't know where what the hell the pumps are, so I'd like someone to point me to the right, to that direction.
Oh, maybe you could go somewhere else.
Oh, sure, I could go somewhere else.
It's
look at Piper. Look at that, you know, all those running. It's so... Okay, where's... Okay, where?
Wow.
Okay. Okay, and then she's... Oh, she's back. She's... Okay.
Well, you wanted bugs, so you have it.
Well, yeah, like I said, pathfinding... Well, it's a game by Bethesda, so... What? So it wasn't her, right? Or was it her and she just... It's like Sherlock Holmes again, you know, that Sherlock Holmes back in, you know, I don't know, like six years ago.
Amazing videos.
With Watson.
Yeah. Okay. Creepy Watson.
So let's continue. I'll come back for the pipes and get the money that he owes me. And so when you actually run like this, you use... action points or active points, I'm not too sure what AP stands for anymore. And and then there's the points you need when you actually use the VATS.
So can you get a horse and can you go up vertical cliffs with the
the horse? No horses, no cars or, you know, vehicles of any kind. It's just you walking and running. Oh,
and fast traveling.
I like this song. It's the end of the world. Actually, it reminds me of Ally McBeal, where Vonda Shepard used to sing the song, or at least she did sing the song once. And I remember.
You remember.
I remember, but I know my favorite song is the one where the guy says he doesn't want to set the world on fire. That's really one I like.
Appropriate, I guess.
More or less. So, yeah. As you can see, it's nice to wander around, but not all of action here.
So, yeah, right now, and usually in the exteriors, strangely, the frame rate is okay until at least there is a lot of action. It's usually the interiors where we've got people asking about the FPS. Because the frame rate, of course. Because right now it seems good.
Well, there have been a few drops here and there. Just a few minutes ago, maybe. But it's not that big of a problem. The minute you are in the city with the buildings everywhere, and well, they don't look very nice. You know, they're basically big blocky things. It's like, you know, 3D Tetris in a way. And then it starts to freeze a lot more, to slow down more, and well, add to that some enemies, and it can go below 15 frames per second, even less. If, you know, when the game freezes, it's at least 1 second. I actually haven't counted, it's yeah, it's not good, and it's not acceptable considering how the game looks. So the better actually come up with a patch very soon, because I don't think people are going to be very tolerant. And so you can see here, in third person view, it's even less. There's stutter when actually was trying to. It was not me or the stream. It was in first person view. It actually doesn't do it. But
can you go from one to the other and show?
Maybe. Well, it wasn't doing it anymore here. So maybe because it, you know, it's loaded the area. I don't know. The thing is, I haven't seen that much frame drops in the open world as I was playing in first person view, and now it seems to me there's a bit more, you know, a bit more drops than, you know, now that I'm playing with a third person. But it might just be me. Oh, there's a plane here. I like the guy talking.
Oh.
Yeah, there's. Okay, so there's a.
So as soon as it's a raider, you know, he's hostile.
Yeah, raiders are not nice.
Right. Yeah, I started saying that the Digital Foundry had a video showing the Xbox One version dropping to 0 FPS because there was a freeze. It also happens on the PlayStation 4 version.
It also happens on the PlayStation 4
version. You can see it in one of our videos. Which one is it? The Pikmin?
The Pikmin Gallery. Just the very few seconds, not even minutes. I use the shotgun and it freezes. And that guy is actually having a seizure after his death.
Well, that's... Well, you see it. You see that.
No. So see here... Some stuttering I just saw.
And in first person, is the same thing?
Well, not now anymore, but not sure it's... Like I said, you know, I haven't seen that much stuttering and frame drops playing in first person view when I was in the open world like this. And you can see that, yeah, my radiation level has risen up. Because I was careless, so which means even if I do try to, you know, use a steam hack, it's not going to go further than you know, the red bar. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to travel to I found another place I didn't know.
So you can fast travel as soon as you're not in a fight. You can fast travel anywhere
sure.
You want,
as long as you've discovered the place. You know, it's pretty
right.
You know, normal, what you'd expect from any games now, open world. I was looking for a place where actually I had found I think that's in this area. There's an insane asylum that I haven't visited, but I was quite curious to actually see the inside. You know, at least ghouls or even more, you know, even scarier things in there. And there was a place where there was a raider settlement, and there were two death claws around. And I actually triggered the alarm on purpose. I climbed up the tower and I clicked. You know, trigger the alarm, and so the two death claws actually arrived and bit the shit out of the raiders, and they killed them all. Problem is, you know, when I wanted to loot the place, then the death claw came back, and I died a few times. So that's the asylum, and there's probably something to do inside. No doubt about that. So unless you really want me to go and find out, I'll just stay in the open world. And you can see it again, you know, when you're in the open world, it looks pretty nice, and the trees and everything. And oh, it's not the best looking game ever, but it works. And when the game is smooth, well, there's nothing to say. Oh, that was the tower I was talking about. So, are there more Deathclaws or and Raiders, or are they still the their buddies actually? Oh, there's a couch outside. So you could, well, actually, let's climb up there and look at the view.
Let's.
Oh, actually, that's new. Let's disarm it. Don't want to die. So, which means, you know, maybe there are some new guys. Or maybe I died and I didn't save the last time I came, but I don't think so. I think I stayed for a pretty long time trying to get rid of the death claws. And so, see, I can activate. So, I don't know, maybe it resets. Can't see anyone though.
Yeah, it seems pretty dead.
Oh, there's sure. No, there's another guy over there. Let's activate the alarm and see what happens. Let's try not to. Oh, see, a Deathclaw over there.
And did it kill the guy?
I think it did.
Yeah.
See?
Oh, yeah. Can you use VATS at this distance?
Sure, I could. Except I have no bullets for this weapon, and
yeah, sure.
Even if I had, and you know, plus it's an Alpha Deathclaw. like I said, I killed one of these. I used one mini nuke, and also I think I had something like, you know, this gun that helped me a lot, some grenades, and you know, as long as you keep your distance, which, you know, it's not always easy to do. Actually, not probably my best idea to actually hit. So it's gonna leave, I guess. It's not gonna stop, is it? I said stop.
No, it's okay.
Okay.
You're doomed.
No, just I can run. I can outrun it. Run it. I'm sure. So you can see, you know. Well, I'm sure on PC is, you know, the field of view and everything is gonna look way better. And actually, might have a clue tomorrow if Miguel has time to capture some footage.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see the difference, because it looks like, from what I saw on GAF, that there is some texture streaming issue on PC.
Oh, really?
Where the textures are actually worse than the PlayStation 4 version.
Oh my god. You have got to be kidding.
Well, it's Bethesda, so everything is possible.
Well, it's really a shame, because yeah, again, just not acceptable. And I think the best, you know, way to answer to that would be sort of boycott the game, as long as it doesn't run at least smoothly on consoles in any type of situations.
Oh, no. So for some reason, people had no... Well, for some reason, we all know why, but had no problem boycotting the PC version of Batman. Well, it's almost as bad, to be fair, in terms of frame rate and everything.
Well, yeah, except for Batman, the console versions were good. But
sure.
And you know, I'm sure people are going to say, yeah, but it's a, you know, it's a console game, so that's why. But it, you know, a game like this, it should run way smoother than it does now. And I'm, you know, I have no problem with 30 frames per second, really. I didn't mind playing the game, and I'm just I wish I could have gotten the PC version, so like I would have played on the PC and hopefully I would have gotten a smoother frame rate, because that's something that has, you know, bugged me, no pun intended, for ever since I started playing on PS4. And I wish there were a crossplay option so I could continue on PC, but
yeah, good luck with that.
No, there's not going to be, and there's no way I'm going to, you know, play the beginning and everything in the 24 or 5, 6 hours I've played on PlayStation 4. I'm not going to do it again on PC because, you know,
yeah,
I don't have the time for this, and the game is not that
and
great.
You're too old for this shit
also. So you see that, you know, some raiders, I guess the mercenaries, sorry, actually fighting the super mutants who were attacking me before. So, you know, it's, you know,
let's just go.
Yeah, let's just go. And, you know, well, actually looks pretty nice.
So
here.
The question, do you think the game was overhyped?
In a way, I would say yes.
There's no way it could have lived up to the hype anyway, but
no,
it's pretty far from.
And the
perfect,
thing is,
sure,
is maybe I'm mistaken, but I think the hype mainly comes from the players only, because, you know, well, Bethesda, you know, they've actually released a few videos over time, but I
on YouTube only.
Well, yeah, that's why we never actually.
Maybe they had something to hide.
Yeah, sure, possibly.
No.
So
no,
which
well, they went exclusive for all their titles and not just Fallout 4, sadly. So, yeah.
But, you know, I never really felt that, even though on YouTube. So another mercenary. Is he? Okay, so I'm trespassing, so I'll leave. I don't feel welcome here.
So people are asking about the dialogues. It's always 4 options max, or do you
pretty much
there's more?
Pretty much, as far as I can remember, it's yeah. It's around 4. Ooh, what happened? Oh no, I hate these guys. So I'll run.
I think you like a lot of people.
No, well, you know. There was a legendary. I also hate these, you know, bugs and. Oh, just. And they actually keep falling. The funny thing I saw, maybe that was a bug.
Wow, 20 rats. Just touching them.
Yeah, and almost dying because I'm attacked by a mosquito or something. I was chased by some kind of a fly or something, and I really don't have any ammo. I'm going to die here.
Killed by bugs. Yeah.
Oh, no ammo. I'm out of everything.
Seems appropriate.
Actually, it's a pretty crazy.
So yeah, one big change of the VAT system
is that you can die when using it because it doesn't stop time. It just slows it down. That's all.
And you're going to enjoy a loading time. The double punishment of when you punishment, I guess, from when you die. First you die, and then you have to wait.
But you get to see a very nice weapon.
Yeah, if you remember my review of Assassin's Creed Unity last year, how crazy I was getting with the loading times. This is even worse, I think. Well, at least you can rotate a model around, but this is terrible.
Well, there's more exciting things to do when you play video games than to rotate a sniper rifle.
Well, it's better than the black screen.
Sure. Okay. Shoot me now. Okay, so I'm back to, back to the, I don't know actually where I am anymore. But I remember these guys were there. And still, I haven't been able to hear the song I prefer. I feel cheated. Another new place. I thought I had found. Oh no, actually, that's the place that I had found, but I went there and I got killed, so I never came back. Oh! I hate mines also.
How many things do you hate in this game?
Well, a lot of things. Although, funnily enough, I hated the game at first, I came to enjoy it.
I think you. I've never seen you rage that long about a game. The first few days,
my song
was like you. Sorry, so I'm going to shut up.
We can't turn the volume up. I need to enjoy it.
Right, right.
Thank you. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No. Oh no. I'm listening to the music. You... Normal for other journalists. That's what I should take in. All ambition for worldly acclaim.
I just want to be the one. Buzzing? So people, many people are asking for you to sing along.
Yeah, only the part where I know the words. Many people, I don't believe you though. Believe
me, I want to set the world on fire.
Yeah, that was me singing, and that's about all you get.
We all know you can sing. You can sing.
Yeah. I've had time to practice with this one, but still not the best. Oh, green top, not sorry.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to stop.
I need to get the OST. Provided it has the all the retro songs. Or I need to find them because, well.
Yeah. It's not like they recorded them specially for the game.
No, they're actually also Billie Holiday.
Really?
Yeah. It's not Strange Fruit, but
nobody else ain't gonna do.
I like it. Look in here.
Yeah, yeah. It's looking nice.
All ambition.
Like there is some kind of moss or something in the trees.
Looks very, very nice.
Yeah.
I like these moments.
Almost like vegetation.
Almost, it's a lot brighter and colorful than before. It's been. I don't want to set the world on fire. Okay, missed it.
Nope. Yeah.
Nah, this is what you get when you. I could hear the bugs. Come on! Oh, I'm not.
Come on, you good with bitches.
Oh. Shoot! Come on!
Girls! Girls! Okay. Watch out! Might you put the sun down now?
Oh. Too bad. Probably more enjoyable for the people to listen to than our voices. Is it that she's. He's the devil. He's the. Something like that.
He's a drifter.
No.
So, can you go near the water?
I can.
Okay, I think Loakum has a strange
question.
Strange thing with incest.
Yeah, so I was going to say, if it's anything about incest, please keep it for yourself.
Yeah, yeah. It's.
Let's take a look at the cows. Very nice cows.
Mutated cows, yeah.
Would you like some milk?
No, thank you.
Oh, double heads. But they're at least they're not hostile.
Surprising. They're not hostile, yeah.
Yeah, they are.
They could breathe fire or something.
Oh, they're just...
So can you swim or is it radioactive?
I think here it would be a radioactive, but in some places the water is not that bad, at least when you quickly walk through it. What you can try to do, is it? See, oh, puddles actually.
Ripples, yeah.
Ripples, yeah, not puddles. What am I saying? Ripples, but. Okay, here it makes sense. Okay, first time actually there were ripples further than where I was shooting. So, okay, I'll try to swim, you know, I don't really care if my character dies now. Oh, here. Oh no, I'm not gonna drink. So it's still radioactive, so no big surprise. But actually, it's I'm not too sure because I don't remember when the story, you know, was set in Fallout 3 and New Vegas. But it seems that the world is actually, you know, coming back to life more. There's more vibrant colors. There's more vegetation and.
Well, yeah, but it's not in the middle of the desert in the first place, so.
True for New Vegas. Yeah, that's true. That's true. And you can see here there are settlers, I guess, because these are. Actually, it's nice to walk around and just visit.
Yeah.
Oh, except there are bugs.
If there was a peaceful option where you just walk around and may assure that, and you're never going to encounter any hostile, I would enjoy it, but too much fighting for me.
Yeah, true. Even without the fightings and everything, the way the graphics sometimes look is, well, most of the time the way they look, it would probably also become a problem to you when just simply wanting to visit and to enjoy the, you know, the nice views. And
so what's I'm not seeing it right on the screen. What's flying?
It's the Brotherhood of Steel. It's a group you can join also.
Wow, so and, it's got some and pretty big ardor.
Yeah, and they actually. Oh no, come on. And they also actually intervene sometimes, you know, in the open world. More or less helping you without knowing, because, you know, if you're interested in a place like this one where there was a some kind of a similar place, and I think there are actually super mutants over there, because, you know, there's a like a food cache up there, and they actually started shooting at them. So they're attacked also, it seems, and someone is attacking me too apparently.
I guess,
well, you know, time to see the world
in red.
Oh no, come on. And so where's the last guy? There's isn't there one last guy? Oops.
Wow,
and no bugs. So nice. When you
Why does it look like a nuclear explosion?
Because it's a car, and it's a, you know, a car with the radiation on it. I don't know. Don't ask me questions. Okay, so I cut her arm off. Oh, another one.
Was it Trevor?
Yeah, it's actually Trevor. It was. But yeah, like that. Easter egg. So one thing I probably should show you now to maybe finish. I don't know how much time we have left.
We've got 2 minutes.
Okay, so what I could show you, even though I haven't been able to reached level 21, which is normal because, you know, it takes a bit of time to go from one level to the next, is the perk chart. You're gonna wonder how I have been able to spend more than 24 hours in the game and I have only unlocked this. Basically, every time you earn a level, you gain one special point that you can use. And of course, if you want to, you know, maximize your strength so you can carry more things, your perception so you can, you know, make your VATS, VATS, not too sure how people would say that in English actually, more efficient and more precise. Endurance can help you raise your health, and charisma, of course, is what we saw before. So it takes quite a good number of points, which means that I'm now level 20, and that's all I've been able to do. And it's pretty big.
Yeah, it's amazingly big.
And in a way,
if it's even possible to get everything.
I'm not sure. Well, I don't even know if there's a level cap as there was in Fallout 3 before they raised it when they added the DLC. And I hope there's none, because then people are going to be frustrated, because, you know, I tend to think that people are going to, you know, want to upgrade their strength and endurance and maybe charisma or agility for, you know, stealth, or no, it's not stealth, I don't remember which one is stealth, or even luck. And before you start actually getting into more specific abilities, like, you know, being tougher, or like having more deals with the merchants, or like here, being able to restore more health using stim packs and right away, and here as an agent of death itself, as you can read, you can instantly kill someone sleeping, and you have more damage with your silenced weapons, because you can have silenced weapons. I actually have one, I think, in my inventory, if I'm not mistaken. And something I can also show is how you can, when you, okay, suppressed, yeah, like this. So you press R1, and then you choose the slot you want, and you press X, and now, you know, you press one time up, and then you choose your gun.
Convenient.
But, you know, when in the middle of action, it's not always easy to press, okay, which is mine? So you can use the Pip-Boy to do it if you want. Oh.
Oh, you didn't have to do anything.
Well, yeah, sometimes. Well, the weaker enemies mainly, but there was a big boss fight with the Minutemen, with a giant monster thing, and they actually helped me, you know, at least keep the monster busy sometime when I was trying to run away to catch my breath and get some, you know, get a bit of health back. And so, well, you know, they're not indispensable, but they can help. So many discoveries. And what they can do also, and it's probably the biggest help they can actually give, is where's Piper? She's gone. And sometimes it just disappears. I actually lost my dog meat. It disappeared. I have no idea where it is. And well, you know, didn't really care for that dog. So she's back.
There she is.
And you can
creepy
you can,
Piper.
Yeah, you can trade. So which means you can give her anything you're carrying when you see, for example, the next thing I take, it will be too heavy to actually run. But even walking will be very, very slow, and fast travel won't be possible. So you can actually give her your junk, or even your mods, or anything you have. And then you can get it back when you're, you know, back at your settlement, and you know, so she can store a lot of things, and you can also talk to her.
So I've got one question: if you take too much rads, what happens?
Well, eventually,
it stays when you die.
It stays, and well, unless your, you know, save point is before, and you were not, you know, didn't have that much rad as now, but basically you just go to see the doctor, or you use rad away, but if you know, if it's all red, you're dead. So as far as I know, I've never actually tried in either.
So you could hypothetically be in a situation where your checkpoint is in the middle, well, it's checkpoint in the middle of a war zone, and your rats are so low that there's no way.
No, maybe you don't actually.
Or maybe you can fast travel. If there's a checkpoint, you can fast travel.
Yeah, but then again, maybe it's something that I've never done. You know, playing Fallout 3, and I never played New Vegas because I didn't have the time at the time, and I never actually waited to see what would happen. So maybe
we've got Vanity Concubine asking a question. It's been a long time. So aside from its look, does the game play just like your rehash of Fallout 3 or totally new experience?
To me, it's from what I remember of Fallout 3 that I played a lot. Although, like I said, I skipped New Vegas, which was better in terms of story and everything. But it's for me, it felt a lot like playing Fallout 3 again. And all the additions they've put into the mix. The crafting is more important than, you know, taking care of the settlements. It's nice, but it's not something you have to do other than maybe modding your guns and armor, which can help you make your life easier. But it's a lot like Fallout 3, and that's why I was disappointed in that after years of wait. Why can't it be more? Why can't it bring something like, you know, Oblivion brought something in a way, at least in terms of visual at the time. And then Skyrim, they actually brought something. Not too sure what it was, but it didn't feel like playing the same game years after playing Oblivion. True. And here I was like, okay, this is more or less Fallout. And you can see the shadows here. Ooh. You know, little by little, they move. But they don't move continuously, you know, like it's...
Yeah, well, many games have this issue.
Yeah, sure, but I was looking at everything. So, you know, because probably there won't be any incest going on in the game, I can try the relationship.
Okay between us? Well, it's awful nice to be traveling with someone who's got their head on
straight. It's something... Nothing
more. All right between
okay,
us?
No. So it's just because you can flirt with her, but I don't know where this can go. That's all you. But you know, she's not the sister or anything, so that's okay.
Your thoughts?
So yeah.
So can you give orders to your followers?
You can say stay.
Okay.
And that's it.
Okay.
Oh no, you can say go. Sorry. Again. Over there. And then you can say, hey, head over there. Okay. Okay, so she...
Where is she going?
Oh, she's actually taking the long way.
Okay.
Go over there.
Over here.
Which can... you? Well, I guess we can help. I've never really used it in combat, but sometimes they're... Yeah, they're pretty careless and they...
They're not in the way, yeah.
Well, yeah, sometimes they're in the way, and that's also why...
If you point her to on the other side of the water, what is she going to do?
What's up?
On your left.
So first,
on the island.
Yeah, first you need to point at her, and then
yeah,
you need to on the other side over there.
For example.
No, she doesn't want to. Listen, it's too far.
And the closer one on your left, right behind you.
Oh, she. Okay, so she's going over there, over there.
But so you could use her to scout something.
If you want to
check if there is bad people, just send her. She's immortal anyway,
well,
so you could,
but you know, sometimes you... That's never... Oh, I hate... Yeah, that's... These are the guys I...
Okay, hey,
do something. Attack. So you can... But usually you don't need to tell her to attack them. So you can see there's a... You can hear there's a silencer. Okay, let's try my explosive shotgun. Oh, watch out for that explosion.
Yeah, I don't get why is it the explosion this way.
Because it's more impressive, and it actually is one of the things that are impressive in the game. So.
No, but the mushroom.
Oh yeah, but because again, it's more impressive, and it's Fallout. It's, you know.
Yeah, I know, but it's a bit too much. Hey, wow. It's me. You know how I am.
Oh,
something.
Okay.
Anyway, we are way past the 1 hour point now. So yeah, how's the frame rate holding? Let's just finish with this.
Not.
Maybe if you die, it would be better. So
yeah.
We can finish with a
on
phase.
The loading time.
Excellent. Press F to pay respect on the chat, please.
Thank you very much for that. Oh, and one of the guys I really hate to finish, you know, look very nice.
Right. So yeah, the frame rate, it's okay most of the
Sometimes.
time, but when it gets busy, it can get really bad. And it's even if oh, it's not a real action game, it's still a detriment to the gameplay
And to
when
the
it happens.
immersion also immersion because you know you're yeah it's not pleasant to be
Oh yeah, show the shadows. It's not the shadow.
no
Whoa.
it's light
It's
you
a
know
beam, yeah.
yeah
Yeah, so we in the French stream we had the shadows. We could see the buildings in a not
Oh
so far
yeah.
distance completely lit as in sunlight. And when getting closer at like 50 meters, you could actually see the shadows appearing. So it was very jarring.
I'm not sure here. You know one
Yeah.
thing is I've said that I regretted that the number of different songs on Diamond City Radio was not that good.
Yeah.
Tonight I've heard songs I had never heard before, and I don't know why I kept, you know, hearing the same songs over and over
Oh,
again.
someone is saying that the cars have a nuclear engine, so there's a
Oh.
little nuclear explosion when they blow up.
See? There's a reason. I knew.
Right.
I knew it.
All
I
right,
knew.
I'm fine with that. I thought it was all symbolism or something.
But even here, the frame rate drops, and there's no reason, you know. It's and in the city where the, with the
It's because of the
buildings.
radiation inside your eyes. They
Oh,
make you slow down.
well, I'm a mutated reviewer then. But it's
Right.
just a
So
shame because you know.
we had our fail for
It's just a shame because you
Stream,
know.
so I think we are going to finish here unless you have
Yeah.
something more to show.
No,
Well,
it's
you've
just.
got many more things to show, I
Yeah, there
guess,
are many
but
things to show, but you know, like I said, you know, just, you know, like here, it's actually a very nice view. And,
there was something
just.
moving in your view, but
Yeah, I know, there's probably a radar. Yeah, it's. Sometimes you get to. Yeah, you arrive somewhere and you say, okay, yeah, that's. Actually, that was worth it. And then the frame rate takes a hit and you're like, oh, come on, there's no reason why it should do that. And then, you know,
Yeah,
you
and the
get
frame
to.
rate and also the freezes.
And the
It's
freezes.
that's really bad.
And then you get to a place where it's really ugly, usually inside, but sometimes even outside in the city. And you're like, okay, this is not how a game should look in 2015 on PS4, Xbox One, or PC. And I'm really curious to see what the PC version looks like because, well, it has to look better than this and run smoother, even though you said there's a
Yeah,
problem with
well,
the textures.
maybe, who knows, we'll do a stream with the PC version.
Well, I don't have the game myself, so.
Oh yeah, that's true, and I don't think I would be able to provide it to you this time.
Nope, and well, I
We
actually have
don't work with Bethesda directly anymore, so.
our good friend at DL Gamers said, you know, for my birthday a few weeks back, he would grant me any game I wanted, but I don't think I want to waste it on Fallout 4
True.
that I've played for 24 hours on
Yeah,
PS4.
just for the stream. Yeah, we'll just wait for Miguel to get
The video, so.
his new bandwidth, and we should be able to
And
stream.
who knows if yeah, right. I'm looking forward to hearing Miguel's stream.
No, we'll do talking into the playing.
Well, that could be interesting.
Oh yeah.
Okay, nice freeze to finish.
Yeah. Well, a nice fail, I guess. All right, so thank you for watching, guys. We're quite a few people watched the English stream tonight.
Well, thank you for
Thanks
that.
to NeoGAFLink, I guess. And next stream, I have no idea what we're going to do. We'll try to do something next week, if possible. I'm sure we'll find something.
Yeah, I've a lot of games I haven't had time to cover. Not big games, but releases that we skipped because we didn't
have
time.
Yeah, we could do Fallout 3 or Fallout New Vegas.
Actually, I do have Fallout New Vegas, but on PC. But
you can stream PC games.
Yeah, I can,
no
but
no, no, we're not going to do that, of course. But
I didn't start the game, so I bought it because it was on sale, and then I never played it, as everyone, you know, does. So, and Fallout 3, it was on 360. So, well, I guess it could actually run just as good as this one now, if you don't mind
me
trolling.
All right. So, thanks to the guys not from NeoGAF. Also.
Oh, it's good to know.
Yeah, because some people got offended, I guess, that I thought they were coming from GAF. So, you know, we know we've got a few good people also on Gamerside, but we are still a small community.
Oh, actually, found the Brotherhood Scribe.
Anyway, we'll see you hopefully next week or the week afterwards. I don't know.
Well, we'll see. Not sure in terms of releases, apart from maybe the Crew DLC Wild Run coming on September the 17th. There's not much to see before Just Cause 3, I guess, in early December.
All right, so Eurogamer people. Hello.
Oh, Eurogamer listening to watching us and all that. So.
Yeah.
Eurogamer people we don't know?
Eurogamer people, Bork24.
I don't know the name, so I wouldn't know.
Yeah, sorry, me neither. Doesn't seem like a bad guy, so.
But usually they use their real names anyway, so we can't know their, you know.
Anyway, it's now the fourth time I think I'm saying we are going to stop here, so this time will be the good time. All right, see you guys.
See you guys. Thanks.